fish sticks. Love them. You're a gay fish. No, I'm not. Ah! One and only Carlos Mencia. Yeah, viva la México. So, Carlos, you've got a show on Comedy Central, a stand-up tour. Where did you have time to come up with this classic joke? Well, you know, I was just kicking it with my homies and my brain. You know, my brain's always so full of ideas because I'm so funny and stuff. So I was just all like, hey, Pepito, you like fish sticks? And my homeboy says, yeah, Carlos, you know, you're so funny. And it just occurred to me, I was like, oh, man, you must be gay fish, huh?
I'm fashionable, and fish sticks are crunchy.
Yo, Kanye, Kanye, we found him, money.
Kanye West! Oh, shit, man, okay, look, it wasn't me. I didn't really start the fish stick thing, all right?
You're just saying that now because you're scared.
Make fun of me? I'm a genius. I'm the voice of a generation. What are you?
Nothing! Look at me, man! I'm not funny, I steal jokes, my dick don't work, man! I got to piss in a plastic bag, man! I got no dick!
I ain't gonna hurt you. I pay people to do that for me.
Oh, shit, oh no, man! Come on, I got no dick, man!
Now, explain it to me. Why do people think I'm a gay fish?
Cause you like fish dicks, man! Come on, man! Don't you get it, please? Just get it, man!
Why? Look at me! Look at me! I love fish sticks! I love putting fish sticks in my mouth!
You're a gay fish, man!
Same dream. Then
welcome. I'm RJ of the Nerdy Brew, and here on this channel, we talk TV, movies, and everything in between, all while drinking a cup of coffee. Now, if you like one of those things, or all of those things, why don't you consider like, subscribing, and hit that notification bell, and becoming a fellow Brewster. So today, fellow Brewsters, this is a coffee talk on some things I think needed changing in Doctor Strange. And the madness of multiverse. In the multiverse of madness. Now, Doctor Strange in the multiverse of madness is killing it in the box office right now. But it also came out to mixed reviews. We gave it a fair grade based on style over substance, but there was not enough substance within that style. So we gave it a fair grade, and I'll link the video here. And I'll also link it to the end of the video as well, so you can get further along with our thoughts. But I felt like Doctor Strange needed to have a plot adjustment. I felt that there were certain things that needed to be rearranged, certain things that needed to be included, certain things that needed to be excluded. Just a lot of readjustment when it came to the plot in the script. So honestly, I wish that I was Kevin Feige's number two, his concierge, his Tom Hagen, as you will, or his Fennec Shand, and to say, you know what, Mr. Feige, this needs adjustment here, there, cut this out, put this in. I think overall this would be a better movie if we move in this direction. Then you're like, RJ, you're a brilliant mind. I'm glad you're here with Disney and Marvel. And here's all the monies. All the monies.
I'm gonna let this money change us.
What are you talking about? This money is our ticket to the good life. Starting now. I just bought a giant room full of gold coins and I'm gonna dive into it like Scrooge McDuck. It's not a liquid! It's a great many pieces of solid matter that form a hard floor-like surface! Ah!
Right, but I wish I was the script supervisor to the movie. But I would honestly, for myself, take a lot of the elements that they did start in the movie that we did get. But I felt like the movie needed to be acclimated to a particular, honestly, and I'm gonna say this a few times, is going to be a villain. I felt that making Wanda as the de facto villain, I think it hurt Wanda's overall narrative inside the MCU. And I felt like it also hurt the movie and the things that they needed to get through. Even though throughout the comics, Scarlet Witch has always been teeter-tottering with her sanity, teeter-tottering with her allegiance, teeter-tottering with her powers and her abilities. And there were two comic books of Marvel's or of Avengers Disassembled, and there was the House of M. They are two different stories, but they weren't congruent. Not gonna say congruent, but Avengers Disassembled came first, which was like a precursor, and then House of M was a finishing movie. I mean, a finishing story. And that's where they draw a lot of her her mind frame and her characteristics of going bad. And so I just honestly felt like Wanda, in that sense, because you could tell from the Multiverse of Madness that they're building up to a Secret Wars storyline. And within Secret Wars is when it was a combination of different realities, becoming part of incursions. You heard that word in the movie. These incursions were events where realities inside the multiverse were getting destroyed because these realities were colliding with one another. And then it goes to Battle World, was orchestrated by Dr. Doom, and it was just like the survival of these different realities, the Ultimate Universe paired with the main Marvel Universe in the comics. And it was a great storyline, a great event. That was probably like one of the last times I read Marvel, and then it introduced to all different and all new Marvel. Excuse me. But that's what it seems like the MCU is leading to. If it's not going to be the Infinity Saga, you know, after that, this multiverse situation, they're leading up to the Secret Wars. And Secret Wars is a big catastrophic event where it could adjust and change the outlook of the rest of the main MCU storylines that we have. And as I said before, I felt like an external villain who has their own motives, their own villainy, their own characteristics needed to be involved in this movie. And as I said, if I was a script supervisor, if I was part of Kevin Feige's high team, I think the movie needed to incorporate the villain known as Nightmare. And now Nightmare is probably very pivotal, one of the higher tier villains when it comes to Doctor Strange. Even in the comic books, that's his first villain. With them incorporating dreamwalking, dreams, going into other dimensions, Nightmare is part of the dream dimension, and he is the lord of the nightmares, and he's one of seven of the fear lords. That's what they're called, the fear lords, and he's one of seven. But he breaks off from them at a period of time, and he has his own lofty ideas, his own hubris, his own pride, where he just definitely wants to be the head honcho in charge, the HNIC, right? That's what he really wants to be. So with him, everything that they included inside of this movie of America Chavez and her reality jumping powers, right? You have Wanda, who has read the Darkhold, and then you have the ability of dreamwalking, and then you have the multiverse. Now, with Nightmare, he gets the majority of his power. He's a demon, so his abilities are supernatural, and he becomes stronger, more powerful from feeding off of people's fears as one of the fear lords and being part of the dream dimension. And that goes into, and let's just say he's like the Marvel's version of Freddy Krueger. He predates Freddy Krueger, but he would be that kind of villain of causing turmoil and nightmares inside of dreams. And I felt that if he was to be the primary villain of the movie, I feel like it would change the trajectory of the film, adding a little bit of structure to the movie where it adds more motivation for things to make sense. So from what I've been told about the Darkhold, that the Darkhold was from Cthulhu, right? Cthulhu is a Dark Lord villain inside of Marvel who created the Darkhold. And supposedly the temple in the movie that Wanda, the shrine was to, is that it was all orchestrated by him. But we don't have none of that context. So I honestly feel that the Darkhold, just for adjusting for story, should be adjusted to, equated to the author being Nightmare behind it. For Nightmare being a long lasting entity, and for him to know his travels and just to know these certain things. And we'll go back to WandaVision, why that would be so important. But as I said, if I was to be the producer of this, first and foremost, I would cast. I was thinking about this, and who could this be? And I was down to two candidates, and I'm just gonna holler back at the main candidate that I wanted, and it's Luke Evans. I'm part of Fanboy Junction. I'm a co-host from time to time, and on Fanboy Junction, I always come back to Luke Evans when we have our discussions of fan casting. I just feel like he's an underutilized actor. I feel like he's a fantastic actor. I may or may not have a man crush on this man, but I just feel like he needs to be propelled more inside of Hollywood and seeing in films. And just certain nuances that he has done, characteristics and things, and he's also versatile. I just felt like basically his turn in Fast 6 and also his work in Dracula, he would just be a good fit for being Nightmare.
When I was young, my brother always used to say, every man has to have a code. Mine, precision. A team is nothing but pieces you switch out until you get the job done. It's efficient. It works. But you? You're loyal to a fault. Your code is about family. And that's great in the holidays, but it makes you predictable. And in our line of work, predictable means vulnerable. And that means I can reach out and break you whenever I want. This is your loyalty, your gratitude. Fools. You think you are alive because you can fight? You are alive because of me! Because of what I did to save you!
So that'd be casting, and I'd be like, Mr. Feige, Kevin Feige, I think that we should cast this man here, you know, slide across his table of his headshot and say, yeah, Luke Evans is our Nightmare. And I don't think he made it a part of the MCU as of yet, so I would like him to be a part of that. As I said, with having Nightmare being the author of the Darkhold, and we have that ending, the end credit scene of WandaVision, correct? And in that ending of WandaVision, we hear her children saying, Mom, help, help, right? We have that. And, you know, she ends up having solace and peace with herself to know that just acceptance of the grief that she went to, because she was split between herself and her astral self, and her astral self was the image of the Scarlet Witch, right? And I feel like at the start of the movie, we could absolutely have that opening of the tentacle one-eyed monster. And I know he has a name, but I just don't know it. and he's going after America. I think that was a very exciting, eye-catching start of a movie. So you start off with that, but instead of it being Wanda being the reason behind it, it could be Nightmare. And the thing about Nightmare being the villain, antagonist that's causing that, he can really draw demons or minions from his own dimension. That's an ability that he has. So if you have him be there, then that starts the movie, that propels that's one of his minions after, instead of being Wanda, that's after that, right? So you have everything transpire how everything did transpire in that movie. Then we go to the same scene where Doctor Strange goes to Wanda, and I think there needed to be a further conversation of her regret, and also that she got to this place of reconciliation about the events that happened in WandaVision, and also that she says that, look, I removed myself, but we need to also have a scene where she's hearing her kids, feeling her kids, and how they happened in the movie where she woke up. We need that scene of her waking up. Steven.
Every night, same dream.
And every morning, the same nightmare.
Comes, and she's like, look, Steven, I'm actually dealing with a lot of stuff emotionally. But I feel that there's something dark going to me. And she's like, look, I read the Darkhold. He's like, what? Oh my goodness, you read the Darkhold? I don't think that's well. But she's like, look, I think I have an idea about this girl. I think something is after me and her. It's the multiverse. It's a thing. Blah, 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 blah. You know, he knows about it. Exposition dump. Instead of it being her being the motivation, of like, look, I'm just about to turn evil and wreck shop, is Nightmare. Nightmare is the one that propels the movie along. So at this point of Nightmare propelling the movie, him and his minions attack Kamala Taj. But the specific thing that is about Nightmare cannot operate in our world, right? So that's why I was saying it's important that a lot of the things that they incorporated inside the movie could still be applied to what they put in, right? And as we make this readjustment to the story. So, I mean, even though it being Wanda, I think that her reading the Darkhold and having not the Darkhold itself be the corruption, but having Nightmare be the puppet master from her reading it and using her as a weapon would just make more sense narratively for the movie instead of it being her. Because we know that Sam Raimi, the director of the movie, said that he didn't watch all of WandaVision. So I just feel like that takes away from her progression and her growth inside of that story. Well, Wanda of the Scarlet Witch doesn't have her own volition of trying to destroy the world or get these kids or get America. I feel like it all needed to be stemmed from Nightmare. And what would make Nightmare so important, a part of the story, is that him being after America. And we know in the movie America, Chavez is one of a kind. So with America Chavez being one of a kind, that goes in part of having him taking her power, and for him to take all the fear from not just one reality, but from all the realities of getting in people's dreams and nightmares, for him to be the most powerful as being, and that's the only thing that he wants. There doesn't have to be no dark story, not even any, no character growth. Let's just say he wants power, and he wants order, and he feels like for him to live and be satiated is to get on everyone's feet, right? So we have the movie still go off and Wanda still being who she is, but being a tool of Nightmare. Nightmare could be the one that is dream walking through Wanda at some point of the movie. instead of Wanda just being evil for herself and doing the other Jim walk. So we could have it as him using Wanda as his avatar vessel inside the movie, right? And so no, so even if we go back into the movie and meet the Illuminati can't reason with this person who's focused on one thing. I mean, it's the same thing with Wanda, but if it's just a whole entire evil entity all in itself, I think that adds more credence to the motives that's going on. So I feel like while they're running through the multiverse from this character who could dreamwalk, can get Wanda in every universe, I think another thing, I think the movie didn't have enough madness. We had a couple set pieces of different realities, which were beautiful visually and just to show that the multiverse was a thing. But I felt what also hurt this movie is, can we have different genres? Can we have different settings inside of this multiverse? So for example, if they jumped with America, right? And then they jumped into a certain reality and the setting was a noir setting, right? Raining, black and white. That would have been just like an amazing scene to see. And they're dealing with Wanda. She's a Nexus being, and the setting is running through noir, black and white London streets, right, while it's raining. They get out of that world, right? And then they encounter a futuristic kind of world, maybe like Akira, right? And we have Wanda wearing the red jumpsuit like Akira, and just causing mayhem and havoc there, and jumping into another reality where, I don't know, it could be like the Borg from Star Trek, just showing that we don't have to take away the horror elements, but we could apply to make different genres inside of horror while still holding on to Wanda being a tool for the antagonist. And as the movie progresses and goes on, we could just see more of the madness. And I felt like there was, I felt like it was lacking when it came to going and exploring the multiverse. I think the biggest scene that we had of like the difference of the multiverse, really for me personally, I'm not gonna put this on everybody, but for me personally, I honestly felt like when they meant to go see Sinister Strange and that reality was broken, I felt like that was the biggest like hint of this what could happen and this what this is in this particular world. So I just felt like having Nightmare and having Wanda, it had more of a connection where they didn't have to have her not be a villain by herself. They could still use Elizabeth Olsen, but it would have just been better if Nightmare was the puppet master and the orchestrator of all of these to begin with in the movie.
Everything that has transpired has done so according to my design.
Maybe all in all, I think Mordo could have came in. I don't know if the MCU Mordo should have came in, or maybe a variant Mordo, or even both. Maybe you have a decent, valiant, you know, loyal, dutiful Mordo, but you also have the one from the MCU who is faded and tainted, and his mind frame is like, Steven is a problem, magic is a problem, Wanda is a problem, Nightmare is a problem, everybody needs to go, the bill comes due, right?
The bill comes due.
So they have all of that. And Chiwetel Ejiofor, in his performance, he always comes to work. So I honestly just feel if we incorporated Mordo, I don't think it would have been another thing. His scenes were probably about 5 minutes, but I could see him just being part of the team once again. But it could be like, look, we got to stop this bigger threat of Nightmare and Wanda. And then we'll go back to the status quo after the events. I'm fine with the Illuminati dying. They could stay or they could go. Either way, it would have been a culmination of them being shown up or not making it to the end of the movie. But it probably would have been cool if they were able to help. Or maybe definitely an adjustment where Professor X of that world and we had the official, this is another thing that I felt that needed to be in this movie, was White Vision. White Vision should have totally showed up, and maybe he got some coloration to himself, or he could still be white, depending how long time of the movie is. But I felt like, yeah, they should have had Vision show up. And Vision could have been a catalyst for her not to continue to be used by Nightmare in this particular story. But also, if there was Nightmare, or if it was Wanda in the original movie that we have, Vision needed to be a part of that. Vision needed to be her anchor, even though she saw herself. I felt like it was a very specific scene. I felt like the scene was needed for the movie and was very poignant, and shout out to America Chavez for allowing it to happen. But I do feel like in the multiverse of madness, Vision needed to be there. As I said, as an anchor, if Vision came back, he's like, look, I got all my information to from the last Vision, right? From the memories of the fake Vision that you created. We had our conversation, but I had to work through these. I had to work through these things. I mean, he'll say it very poetic and very British, like Paul Bettany is, right? But I just feel like the terminology that he uses is saying that I had to work through this. I had to figure these things out to know who I was. Am I even, like, existential? He had a lot of existential thinking that he needed to get through, right? And I think that he was seeing what happened to Wanda, or if Doctor Strange brought it to his attention, or if he felt the disturbance in the Force, right? He would assist, and he would say to her, you know, I support you. I support you. Get away from this madman who's corrupting you. Whatever wrong that you've done, you know, there's always a way to repent. There's always a way to make it right. Everyone deserves second chances. I have a new second lease on life, right? He could literally say that. And with that, and they're like, look, we're two broken people. We've been through traumatic things together. Let's continue on this journey together. So I felt like if White Vision was there to say those things to her, and if they had another team up of these magical android multiverse people, right, all together to combat Nightmare and Vision, maybe Vision and Professor X, you know, help Wanda, and they talk it out, and it goes through this thing of when it's like a mental conversation, and Vision is like, I can't be corrupted by this situation, like I can't be corrupted by Nightmare, and he's the one to pull out Wanda from the mental scape, the mental cage that she's in, from Nightmare, and if you will, at the climax of the movie, this particular scene, that they're in this, either the temple at the end of the movie, maybe the white mental space that was shown inside the movie, maybe the dream dimension or the nightmare realm, where it all leads to this one conclusion, right? This one location at the conclusion. And we have the scene of, let's say America is captured. You have America captured. You have the imagery of her two kids, of Wanda's two kids. And you have Vision, you have Wong, and you have Doctor Strange, all of this location along with Wanda. And you have Nightmare, and he says, Wanda, join me, imagine what we can do, and you join me and I'll give you back your family, right? And she sees the boys calling out, mom, help, you know, something along those lines. And she's stuck in between this decision, her boys or Vision in the new future and reality. So she's looking and she's thinking about the consequences, and then she looks over to Vision. He has his head, he looks deep in the eyes, and he says, Wanda, right? And Dr. Strange looks, and he says, Wanda, right? And she looks over at Nightmare, she looks at the boy, she says, I'm sorry, boys, I have to let you go. I have to move forward. And mommy will always love you, and mommy knows that you're always safe. Something along those lines. I'm just jumping off the top of the mind. But then Nightmare's like, what? No, this can't be, Wanda. I'm giving you what you want. Choose me. Rah! Right? Evil temper tantrum. And she says, Nightmare, I have a dream that I'm going to live this dream. I have my family. Right? So then they do a magical blast or whatever. And Wong opens up the Book of Ashanti. He reads the Book of Ashanti. And it goes to the conclusion where he gets trapped. Nightmare can't die. People without dreams, it would destroy reality. It's something like that in the comics. So instead of him dying, because he can't, the Book of Ashanti traps him in the nightmare dimension. Or maybe he's fed off of his own nightmares for him to stay alive, but it still makes a, I don't want to say a paradox, but what do you call it? A continuum. You know, they put him in a continuum of where it also will perpetuate the dream realm to also stay functioning. So I think that would have been a very effective scene and conclusion, and it doesn't deter Wanda from where she ends up in her entire show of WandaVision inside this new, you know, my version rendition of Doctor Strange in the Multiverse of Madness. And maybe they use the Book of Ashanti to stop a nightmare once and for all. Instead of it being disintegrated in the middle of the movie, that could have been the MacGuffin that they were looking for. As I said, that they went through different genres inside the multiverse, not seeing different multiverses, but being a part of different multiverses, right? And I just felt like if those things were added to this movie, I think the movie would be more appreciated instead of it coming out with mixed views. But all in all, those are my thoughts. Let me know your thoughts down in the comments below about what would you readjust inside Doctor Strange 2. What would you would have liked inside of Doctor Strange 2? Do you agree? Do you disagree? What are your overall thoughts? Please make sure that you like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I'm going to bring this video to an end. And I want you to be you, do you, see the bigger picture. Have a fantastic day. You deserve it. This is That Channel. Peace.